In this video, I want to say a little bit about the difference between mathematical fractals and real fractals. So mathematically, a fractal is an object that's self-similar across all scales. You can keep zooming in forever and you continue to see the same shape repeated again and again. So in the Koch curve, you zoom in again and again and again, and you can go infinitely small and you keep seeing this shape appear. Real fractals obviously don't have this property that you can zoom in forever. So maybe this Koch curve looks a little bit like a rocky coastline of England or Maine. And if you've seen a picture of a coastline, and we'll look at this in the next unit, if you zoom in, so a coastline is bumpy, and you zoom in and you see bumps, and you zoom in and you see more bumps, and so on. And that behavior persists over several scales, many orders of magnitude perhaps. But eventually, you would start to be zoomed in so much that you'll be looking at individual molecules, to the extent that that's even possible. So it's not going to look like this forever. There's some cutoff scale. Similarly, this fern from a couple days ago, it's dried out a bit now. Still looks pretty nice, I think. Has a fern shape. That fern shape is made up of fern shapes. This fern shape is made up of fern shapes. And it goes on maybe once more, but it doesn't continue forever. So real fractals are different than mathematical fractals in that the self-similarity doesn't go on forever. Sometimes objects like this are said not to be fractals, but to be fractal-like. So more generally, the notion of a mathematical fractal is an abstraction. It's an ideal. It exists in the world of math, but it doesn't really exist exactly in the actual world, the physical world in which we live. And this is not at all unique to fractals. The same is true really for almost any geometry. So think about a circle. Mathematically, geometrically, a circle is defined perfectly. But there are no exact perfect circles in the world. So here's a plate from the dining hall, and it looks pretty circular, but it's not exactly circular. It's a little bit rough. This is pretty old. It's got a chip missing here. So it's approximated very well by a circle. We'd say, hey, this is a circular plate, but it's not a perfect circle. It's not a mathematical circle. And we use circles all the time to describe things that are circle or circle-like to various degrees. The plate, the lid on a jar, somebody's face or head, all can be approximated by circles. Does that approximation make sense? Sometimes yes, sometimes no. It depends on the context. But the geometric concept of circle is still incredibly, incredibly useful. Similarly, the geometric idea, the mathematical idea of fractals are incredibly, incredibly useful. Even though there are no exact perfect mathematical fractals in the real world. So again, this issue between the abstraction you get in math and the real world, sort of comparing the two, is something that comes up across the sciences. It's not unique to fractals at all. And in terms of this course, the question of when is something sufficiently fractal-like that it makes sense to call it a fractal, well, that question is going to come up again in different ways, particularly when we start thinking about scaling and power laws towards the end of the course.